A few months ago, I made a video about monitoring my car battery level, and that got me thinking, why just the battery? Why not monitor my car trips as well? So let's build a car trip tracker without GPS. If you would ask someone to build a trip tracker, they will most likely think of some kind of a microcontroller paired with a GPS receiver, record checkpoints, and plot the path. But there is a less common known way using Wi-Fi geolocation, and Google provides such a service. You can send a list of Wi-Fi access points from a location to their API, and it returns the GPS coordinates for that point. This is really exciting, because using this basic concept, I was able to build this. This is my car trip tracker. It sits in my car and it records all my trips. The trips are saved and hosted on this tiny device, which costs just a few bucks. And you guessed it, it's an ESP8266 device. These pages are hosted on an HTTP server running on the D1 Mini. On the home page, I see a summary of my trips, and when I click here, I get the full list. I can click on any given trip to view and interact with it. From there, I can see the raw GPS coordinates, or view the list of access points MAC addresses. I also have the delete option for both. I will come back for this later. To explain how Wi-Fi geolocation works, I created this sample code. I will link to my code if you want to grab it. So let's go through it. When the D1 Mini boots, it runs the getMyLocation function. In that function, it scans for the surrounding Wi-Fi networks and prints them. Then it prepares the data for the API call. With that payload, it connects to the internet, sets up the SSL connection with Google, and makes the API call. When it gets a response, it prints it. And if everything goes well, it responds with the GPS coordinates. The only thing that happens behind the scene here is the API key setup. You need to get an API key from Google and have the geolocation service enabled on it. If you are not careful, you might get charged, so make sure you stay within the free tier. I will leave a link to the details. Now let's run this and see what we get. And as expected, I got my GPS coordinates. So this is how you can get the GPS location by knowing the surrounding access points. The hardware. Let's talk about that. This is my schematic. It has a D1 Mini connected to two modules, an SD card and a real-time clock. The SD card is used to save the trip files, and the RTC is used to timestamp the trips. As you might already know, the ESP8266 doesn't have an internal clock, so an RTC is needed. When I put everything together, I get this. This was my first prototype. The D1 Mini is in the middle, and the modules are on the sides. But later, I came across this shield. It has the RTC on one side, and the SD card on the other. This made my setup simpler and much smaller, with no loose wires. Here are the two setups, side by side, a big difference. I then attached a USB cable and printed a case, and I was set. The device is plugged into one of the USB outlets in the car. It is only powered when the car is running. When the device boots, it starts looking for my home Wi-Fi. If it finds it, it connects and serves this portal. This allows me to access my trips history. And when it starts and doesn't find my home Wi-Fi, it assumes I am on the road and starts recording a new trip. It does this by creating a new .log file. It uses the current timestamp as the file name. Then it starts saving the list of access points it finds every 10 seconds, and this file looks something like this. These files, I call them trips on the portal. To convert these trips using the Geolocation API, all I have to do is press this button and it generates a new file with the same timestamp, but with a .gps extension. The file contains the results returned from the API calls containing the GPS coordinates. And this file looks something like this. I use Google Maps to plot GPS coordinates on an interactive map. Dealing with big files on the web server was a bit challenging though. The ESP8266 only has 40K of memory. When I tried to load big files from the SD card to memory, it crashed the device. So I used a buffer to send chunks of the file at a time until the entire file is transferred. I then used AJAX to handle the manipulations on the front end to display big files, long lists, or plot maps. That seemed to have solved the limited memory issue, and it worked great. I had so much fun creating this project, and I am very happy with the results. And to be honest, I was surprised on how accurate Geolocation is. I didn't expect that. If you want to give this project a try, buy the shield, grab the bin file, and flash it to the D1 Mini. I built a setup wizard in the device itself, so simply type setup over serial and follow the instructions. So that's it for me. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Peace.